ABC 10 News at 11 starts now.
And good to have you here this midday. I'm Jim Patton. We want to get right to some breaking news. Moments ago, Governor Newsom announcing a $2 billion plan to reopen schools across California. The governor citing a CDC study that found that going to school was not associated with a higher risk of getting COVID-19.
The point of emphasis here is that safety is key. Just reopening a school for in-person instruction on its own is not going to address the issue of safety. We have to focus on these mitigation steps. We have to focus on accountability. We have to focus on issues associated with being much more transparent and much more aggressive as it relates to enforcement.
Now, he said the first to open would be elementary schools. Once a school is given approval to reopen, students will be required to wear masks and school staff will have to wear surgical masks, which will be paid for by the state. Now, state contact tracers will be sent to schools to help coordinate between the schools and health officials. Once vaccines become more widely available, school staff will be prioritized. The governor wants to see schools reopen as early as February, and we will continue to look into the details of this plan, and we'll have more later today on ABC 10 News on air and online. Meanwhile, our stay-at-home order will remain in place at least another 3 weeks. The state's top health officer saying that Southern California, the region, still has 0% ICU capacity.
We've seen a nearly 70%, 68.7% increase in ICU COVID hospitalizations over the last 14 days.
Another surge in cases is expected from the recent holiday travel and gatherings. The stay-at-home order will be in place until ICU capacity gets back to 15%. And here's a quick look at the latest numbers in San Diego. The last batch of tests returning more than 2,500 positive results, accounting for 15% of the group that took the test. And within the last few minutes, the first senior citizens at St. Paul's skilled nursing facility in Bankers Hill receiving the COVID-19 vaccine. ABC 10 News reporter Marie Cornell shows us why administrators there say many of the residents have been looking forward to this day.
We have such excitement with our seniors. This will truly make the difference. This will signal the end of COVID and the end of lockdowns.
Cheryl Wilson is the CEO for St. Paul's Senior Services, which runs independent assisted living and skilled nursing facilities and senior programs in San Diego County. St. Paul's has partnered with CVS to be among the first skilled nursing facility in the county to get their residents vaccinated with the COVID-19 vaccine. 45 of their residents and 95 members of their staff will get vaccinated Wednesday. An opportunity, Cheryl says, many seniors in their community have already had once before.
Many of these seniors went through the vaccine for the polio pandemic back in the 50s. So they understand how incredibly important this is and what a difference it can make in the life of every American and everybody really around the world.
This is part of CVS's vaccination program, where they will spend 12 weeks deploying trained staff members to vaccinate residents and staff of senior living facilities. Cheryl says, though there are employees that have chosen not to participate in this vaccination clinic, many have plans to get their vaccine on January 20th, when the second dose is scheduled to be given. Either way, she believes this is the light at the end of the tunnel many have been waiting for.
This is the first shot. This is the beginning of this journey to become COVID-free.
Marie Cornell, ABC 10 News.
And new today, regulators in the United Kingdom have just approved the AstraZeneca coronavirus vaccine. This is the second vaccine authorized for use in the UK. Here in the US, the FDA has approved the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. British officials say the approval follows, quote, rigorous clinical trials and a thorough analysis of the data by experts. And now to the latest in Washington, where lawmakers are still fighting over the latest stimulus package, even as checks start going out to Americans. ABC's Faith Abube has the latest.
Those $600 stimulus checks finally on the way to millions of Americans. But the prospect of more of that money coming soon now deadlocked on Capitol Hill. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell blocking Democrats' efforts twice to increase the direct payments to $2,000.
Senate will begin a process to bring these three priorities into focus.
McConnell instead introducing his own bill filled with President Trump's demands. The proposal includes $2,000 stimulus checks, a committee to investigate election fraud and repealing protections for social media companies. But the bill might be dead on arrival. While Democrats support the increased stimulus payments, they're calling the unrelated items poison pills.
So we can get this done, but Leader McConnell has to get out of the way.
The stalemate is also stalling progress on another agenda item, a vote to override President Trump's veto of the annual defense authorization bill.
Now it is time for the Senate to step up to the plate and do what the working families of this country overwhelmingly want us to do.
But the president dialing up the pressure on his own party to get a deal done, tweeting, unless Republicans have a death wish, they must approve the $2,000 payments ASAP. A growing number of Republicans, including the two GOP senators in that critical Georgia runoff next week, are supporting the president's calls. For now, it's unclear whether the extra stimulus boost will ever come, but many Americans ready to receive the $600 checks coming their way.
Right now I'm not working, and you know, anything that is out here for us to actually get is well worth it.
And President,
well, that new strain of the coronavirus has been found in the U.S. First detected by British officials, it is believed to be more contagious. The state of Colorado confirming the first case and working to confirm a possible second. ABC 10 News anchor Mary McKenzie explains what doctors are watching for and what it could mean long term.
It's more than likely that it is here in much, much larger amounts that are currently being detected.
Dr. Abby Olulade with Sharp Reese Steele says the new variant is a result of the virus mutating, which isn't unusual. In fact, scientists see new variants all the time. What's concerning about this one is how contagious it appears to be. British officials saying it's as much as 70% more transmissible. The first cases appearing in the UK, quickly spreading to a number of other countries, and now officially that includes the US. The first case confirmed in Colorado. A man in his 20s with no travel history. Health officials there doing contact tracing. The first patient recovering. A second possible case as well. Both members of the National Guard deployed to a nursing home outside of Colorado Springs, according to our sister station there. Health officials in Los Angeles are now also doing randomized testing to see if the same variant may be partly responsible for the recent explosion in cases there. Dr. Paul Offit says it still hasn't been proven that this strain is more contagious, but it certainly does appear to be. The good news, doctors seem to agree that the vaccines we have right now will very likely be effective against this strain as well.
What they did was they took sera from people who had survived COVID-19 and then looked in the laboratory to see whether or not that sera neutralized this variant virus, and it did, in the same way that it would neutralize the non-variant strain. So that's a very good sign for the vaccine.
Dr. Olulade says there are conversations, too, happening within the scientific community about what a new variant could mean for the virus long term, that it could be with us for a long time, like the flu, and the vaccine would eventually have to change to adapt to new strains. The protocols are the same regardless: hand washing, wearing masks, and keeping your distance from others. Mary McKenzie, ABC 10 News.
And you can get all the latest updates and information on coronavirus in San Diego on our free 10 News smartphone app.